If you have a garden, you're probably familiar with this dude taking a dump on my finger right now. Get off there. This, commonly referred to as a tomato caterpillar,
it's actually a tobacco caterpillar, Manduca sexta.
See the white V shape? And also the red horn is an indicator that you have the tobacco horned worm or horned caterpillar.
Now, like nature commonly does, these guys might be a pest to us in our garden, but if you can manage to keep them around and not kill them off, they actually create a awesome pest defense. And that is in the form of a parasitic wasp that is beneficial to your garden once this guy fosters the nutrition for them by essentially being parasitized. Now, we don't want to eradicate this fella. There are so many benefits to the wasps that will be birthed from this guy's being. Now, there are many caterpillars that in one way or another are ones you should avoid because of either toxins that they have in their little bristly furs, or they're poisonous, or they can bite. But this guy is harmless despite his little horn. So the braconid wasp, right here, commonly used in pest control and agriculture, parasitizes this fella by laying eggs in his back that will eventually hatch, and they will consume this guy slowly, keeping him alive, almost zombifying him. So if you see the Manduca sexta or the Manduca quincumaculata, which is the tomato with the black horn, instead remove them from your garden, seeing as they are in fact harmless. Take some of your tomato trimmings, because you should, to help aerate and get air between the branches of your tomatoes, which will help with disease and also help fruiting. Take your trimmings and these guys when you find them, and take them somewhere far away from your garden. Maybe to the other side of your property, far away from your tomato plants. But you still want to give them a chance to have the wasp still has a chance to find them. Those wasps will truly, truly help cut down on many, many garden pests and also their pollinators. Here's a picture of the braconid after it has set its eggs into one of the two of these caterpillars. It's pretty gnarly. Well, the one downside to the braconid wasp is that they do not discriminate, and they will go after the butterfly population as well. Combat this by putting up plenty of pollinating flowers, wildflowers, and tons of things like milkweed. That way you have an abundance of nectar-bearing plants that they can all share, and you can kind of keep the balance in your garden. Now, if you don't want them to ever get onto your plants, then try using some very jagged mulch underneath or pencil shavings. They're going to go after your salinaceous plants, so i.e. your eggplant, your pepper, your potato, your tomato. If you would like to see my spray recipe for keeping pests naturally without killing them off of your plants, then let me know in the comments section below. Maybe I'll do that tomorrow for my video. This is just one of the many things that we look at like it's a pest and we run to quell the issue, not knowing that there is a bigger picture and a much grander design. All the more reason to hit those books, study, and do your own research. Thanks for stopping in, guys. If you liked that video, you want more gardening tips, you want to know more about nature, foraging, herbal remedies, medicines, things like that, follow my channel. Giving me a like and a share, a follow and a comment, saving it, really, really helps me in the algorithm. Check out my merch store and my link tree, and also follow me on YouTube under the same name, Deadeye Two Tongues. I love you all so very much. I hope you have a wonderful day. I hope your garden's doing great. And guys, stay wild.